Now, some libraries are less about solving a particular domain of problems and more about enabling the programmer to design their own solutions. And I call these programming power tools. And the first example I'm going to highlight is called Thrust. Now, C++ programmers will know about the Standard Template Library, or STL. STL provides a set of incredibly useful abstractions that are organized into containers and iterators. Thrust provides a data parallel analog to the STL for CUDA, and also borrows niceties from the popular Boost library. Thrust allows host code that runs on the CPU to very easily create and manipulate data on the GPU. Now, the principal container abstraction in Thrust is device vector. Okay, and this is analogous to the vector container in STL, but as the name implies, it lives on the device, on the GPU. Like the STL vector container, Thrust device vectors are generic containers, which means they're able to hold any data type, and they can be resized dynamically. So once your data is in a device vector, you can do a bunch of things trivially. You can do things like sort the device vector or perform a scan operation on it. You can do a reduction operation or a reduce by key operation where you actually take a vector and reduce it according to a key that's in another vector. So for example, if you have a device vector x, in this case it's got three elements and it's of type float, then I can do a reduction on those three elements by just saying thrust reduce, pass in x.begin and x.end to indicate that I'm going to reduce over the entire range of the vector, and it'll give me the result. Or you can do a reduction of a different sort. So rather than simply doing a sum reduce, we can pass in an operator to use, or a functor. In this case, we'll do thrust maximum. So in this case, this reduction will give us the maximum number in this vector. You can also do more general transformations. You can transform one or more input vectors into an output vector. For instance, you could do a vector addition operation, taking two vectors and adding them into a third vector using the built-in thrust plus operator. Or you can apply a user-defined transformation using a functor, and this is a chunk of code that you give thrust and tell it, run this on every element or, you know, on the collection of input and output elements that I'm interested in. And you can interoperate with CUDA code, so you can mix up thrust code, which is running on the host and doing things on the device, but if you then need to do something that's not built into thrust or that's difficult to do with thrust, and you've got some raw CUDA kernels that you want to run, then you can simply get the pointer to a device vector, to the data in a device vector, or hand a pointer to thrust to wrap up as a device vector. In the end, using thrust is a good idea because it helps you avoid writing a lot of error-prone, sort of cut-and-paste boilerplate code, and you can exploit high-performance implementations of these data parallel primitives like sort and scan and reduce by key. These have all been implemented by CUDA ninjas for you so that you can just reuse that code. So thrust can be very handy. We're going to give you thrust code that sorts 10 to the 6 floats. And we're going to ask you to time it. Then we're going to ask you to also time sorting 10 to the 5th and 10 to the 7th floats. And then enter here how long it took to sort 10 to the 5th floats, 10 to the 6th floats, 10 to the 7th floats, and 10 to the 5th, 10 to the 6th, and 10 to the 7th bytes. And enter your answer in milliseconds, and we'll just check to within a significant digit or so.